Thank you.
Okay, we will move to Mr. Johari. You have 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'd like to take the discussion back to the plan. But before I ask the question from Minister Bains, I'd like to make a statement. I do believe we have a very clear plan, and I'm proud of our budget 2016. I'd like to actually cite page 110 of our plan, which clearly lays out the innovation agenda. A copy of that is available if any of my colleagues want to follow as I'm asking the question. This plan is strategic, it's focused, and it's based on a number of pillars. Mr. Bain, a couple of minutes ago, you touched on those pillars. It has key drivers, it has enablers, and it has backed up with strategic investments. If I may ask you, sir, can you circle back and really cover an overview of this plan in this framework and tell us how this framework is going to help us shape the agenda that we are planning to do over the next year and how specifically these drivers and these enablers work hand in hand to give us the growth that we need?
Thank you very much for that question. The one point I want to highlight is that innovation is not going to happen overnight. And so this is a long-term commitment that we made as a government. So that's point one. Point two is we have an amazing department. So not only do I get the pleasure of working with my colleagues, but we have StatsCan, we have the Canadian Space Agency, we have all the regional economic development agencies, we have Destination Canada, we have the granting councils, we have BDC. So we have 15 different portfolios that are going to be aligned as a whole of department initiative to really help drive this innovation agenda. Secondly, it's about the whole of government. So this innovation agenda is saying, look, we as a government have a responsibility through our respective departments to really drive this agenda. So I'll give you an example on procurement. We procure in the billions of dollars. And as I said before, we invest a lot in startups. We do a really good job. But when they want to do business with Canada, when they want to do business with our government, we find every excuse in the book not to do it. It's very frustrating. So if you ask these small business owners, and Bardish, Ms. Chagger and I have talked about this, and she's raised this issue time and time again, we've heard it at roundtable time and time again, these businesses that start up are looking for their technology, their innovation to be validated. So why can't we provide some sort of demonstration program or some sort of procurement initiative to really create an opportunity for them to go abroad and say, yes, we do the business, we do business with the government of Canada. So that's an example of whole of government, and that same kind of mindset will prevail throughout the different departments. So our department will play a leadership role. We're going to work with the entire, with our cabinet colleagues to help drive this agenda. And secondly, when it comes to strategic, as I said before, it's not simply government. Industry is going to help drive this. They take risks. They're the ones that, you know, invest in R&D. They're the ones that create the jobs. They're the ones that come up with the products. So they got to put some skin in the game as well. If you look at the balance sheet for some of the large companies or some of the companies across the board, they hold about 11% in cash holdings right now. They're not investing their money in innovation. They're not investing their money in R&D. They're not taking risk. Why is that? And so the onus is on them as well. And then we spend money across the country. Different provinces and different municipalities have unique initiatives when it comes to the innovation agenda, right? Before we talked about diversification. So how do we better align that? How do we make sure we're not duplicating efforts? How do we leverage that? And I'll be working with my provincial and territorial counterparts because we built such a good relationship during the agreement on internal trade that was mentioned before that we said, okay, that's great. If we're confident that we can overcome that and deal with that issue, what's the next item? The next item is slow growth, and to deal with that is innovation. So I think strategically, we understand the importance of this initiative. It is a big issue. It's going to require a long-term lens. It's going to require a lot of energy, a lot of effort from a lot of different stakeholders. And so what I want to also highlight is that I don't want to spend too much time on analysis. I don't want to spend too many times on reports. I want to focus now on an action plan. I want to focus on outcomes because people are looking for outcomes. People are saying, we know what the issues are. I mean, there might be some new areas that we need to do analysis around artificial intelligence or big data or the Internet of Things. So those areas we have to explore and do additional analysis and say, look, what kind of disruptive technologies are we dealing with and how will that impact our innovative economy? but we know what we need to do with respect to increasing R&D investments, to helping companies scale up, to really allowing, you know, us to become a global hub for entrepreneurship. And that's what I articulated before. So it's really about putting forward an agenda that's meaningful. And if you look at this budget, if you look at all the initiatives, as Minister Chagra mentioned, from the Canadian Space Agency to broadband, to IRAP, to the Post-Secondary Institute Infrastructure Initiative, to the Cluster Initiative, that's combined $4.6 billion we're investing in infrastructure. So we're not just talking the talk. We are actually making significant investments to drive that agenda. And I think that's very important because it sends a very clear signal to our partners, our allies, and different levels of government that we're serious about this, and we're very committed.